I am Aligai Lingappa, Assistant Professor in Physics, Government Postgraduate College, Sirigupa. Today's my chapter is a diffraction of light. So now I will discuss about expression for intensity of light in case of Fraunhofer diffraction at a double slit. So previous class we studied the expression for intensity of light in case of Fraunhofer diffraction at a single slit. So today we have discussed about the Fraunhofer diffraction in a double slits. So let us see the diagram. Let S be the monochromatic source of light. Light from the monochromatic source is made to incident on a convex lens such that the sources are the principal plane of the convex lens. The light emerging from the convex lens is a parallel beam of light. So further, the parallel beam of light is made to incident on the double slits system, say S1 and S2. So where AB is the width of the slit S1 and CD is the width of the slit S2. So that means where the plane wavefront, its width that must be equal to D plus D dash. So the incident parallel beam of light at the position of the double slits which undergoes diffraction. The incident beam which gets diffracted. The diffracted beam of light is made to pass through another convex lens L. So then the incident light which undergoes refraction. The refracted beams are light made to incident on the screen XY. As such that the diffraction pattern will be obtained on the screen. So where the screen which is placed at the principal plane of the convex lens L1. Let where O be the point where the number of rays they will emit, they are in the same phase, so called we will get the brightest fringe, so called central primary maximum. So again the central primary maximum, so surrounded by the alternating secondary minima and secondary maxima. So let us consider one of the arbitrary point on the screen, say point P, which is at a certain distance from the point O. Where point P either a minima or a maxima, that depend on the path difference between the waves they will meet at a point P. So called the phenomenon of diffraction which takes place at a double slit. Let a parallel beam at monochromatic light of wavelength lambda be incident normally upon two parallel slits AB and CD, each of width D, are separated by the opaque space D dash. So the distance between the corresponding points of the two slits is D plus D dash. So where the the source of monochromatic light, the diverging beam of light from the source S is made to incident on a convex lens. If the source is placed exactly at the principal plane of the convex lens, then the nature of the beam emerging from the convex lens should be parallel beam of light. So the parallel beam of light is made to incident on the parallel slits AB and CD, where the beam which gets diffracted, which undergoes the phenomenon of diffraction, where DB the width of each slit, say AB and CD. So both they are separated by a distance d dash. Then the distance between the corresponding points of the two slits is d plus d dash. Let the diffracted light be focused by a convex lens L on a screen XY, placed in the focal plane of the lens. The pattern obtained on the screen is the diffraction pattern. Due to a single slit on which a system of interference fringes is superposed, by Huygens principle, every point in the slits AB and CD sends out secondary wavelets in all directions. So what we know, that the principle of Huygens, so the points of, if they are lies in the same state of vibration, locus of all the particles or all the points, if they are in the same state of vibration or in the same state of or in the same phase, then such a pattern is called a wavefront. So here the wavefront, so that means where every point in that wavefront which emits a secondary sources, so they are called as secondary wavelets. Every point in that wavefront they produces a secondary disturbances, they are called secondary wavelets. So that means sends out secondary wavelets in all directions. From the theory of diffraction at a single slit, the resultant amplitude due to wavelets diffracted from each slit in a direction theta, which is given by a sin alpha by alpha, where A is constant and alpha is equal to pi d sin theta by lambda. Here alpha is equal to pi d sin theta by lambda. So to be taken from the Fraunhofer diffraction at a single slit, we can therefore consider the two slits as equivalent to two coherent sources placed at the middle points, so S1 and S2 of these slits, and each sending a wavelets of amplitude A sin alpha by alpha in the direction of theta. So then assuming that, or consider where two slits S1 and S2, they are equivalent to two coherent sources, they produced or they sending wavelets of same amplitude, same frequency, they are called identical wavelets. So of amplitude A sin alpha by alpha in the direction of theta. Therefore, the resultant amplitude at a point P on the screen will be the resultant of interference between two waves of same amplitude. say A sin alpha by alpha, and having a phase difference pi and a path difference delta. Let us draw S1N perpendicular to S2N. The path difference between the wavelets from S1 and S2 in the direction of theta, which is equal to S2N, which is equal to d plus d dash sine theta. So what we know that in case of single slit experiment, the path difference delta is equal to d sine theta, where d is the width of the single slit. Similarly, so draw the line S1N perpendicular to S2N. The path difference between the wavelets from the slit S1 and the slit S2 in the direction of theta, which is equal to S2N. So which is equal to d plus d dash sin theta. Hence, the phase difference is equal to delta is equal to 2 pi by lambda into path difference. The phase difference is delta is equal to 2 pi by lambda into d plus d dash sin theta. So the phase difference is delta is equal to 2 pi by lambda into path difference. That means the relation between the phase difference and the path difference. So then we have a path difference which can be replaced by d plus d dash sin theta. So then further we will get a phase difference is delta. So phase difference, this is not delta, say pi. Pi is equal to 2 pi by lambda into d plus d dash sin theta. So let a parallel beam of monochromatic light of wavelength lambda be incident normally upon a narrow slit of width AB is equal to D. Let diffracted light be focused by a convex lens L on a screen placed in the focal plane of the lens. The diffraction pattern obtained on the screen consists of a central bright band having alternating dark and weak bright bands of decreasing intensity on both sides. In terms of wave theory, a plane wavefront is incident on the slit AB. Then according to the Huygens principle, each point in AB sends out secondary wavelets in all directions. So then the resultant amplitude R and P can be determined by the vector amplitude diagram. So which gives, so now you see the vector diagram OAB, where R hypotenuse. So then AB, that must be equal to A sin alpha by alpha. Then OA, which is equal to A sin alpha by alpha. OB is equal to R. So where OB, that indicates the resultant amplitude. So this is what about law of addition of vectors. Say draw the OA if it is extended up to the point C, where OA is which makes an angle theta with the AB as shown in the diagram. Then OB from the diagram. So we have OB square is equal to OA square plus AB square plus 2 OA AB cos BAC. Then further R square is equal to A sin alpha by alpha whole square plus A sin alpha by alpha whole square plus 2 into A sin alpha by alpha into A sin alpha by alpha into cos delta. Then further cos square, R square is equal to A sin alpha by alpha whole square 2 into 2 plus 2 cos delta is equal to A square sin square alpha by alpha square, then 4 cos square delta by 2. Then further R square is equal to 4 A square sin square alpha by alpha square cos square beta, where beta is equal to delta by 2, which is equal to D plus D dash into sine theta. So therefore, the resultant intensity at P, which is given by I is equal to half square, which is equal to 4 into A square sin square alpha, sin square alpha by alpha square cos square beta. Thus, the intensity in the resultant pattern depends on two factors. Sin square alpha by alpha square, which gives the diffraction pattern due to each individual states. Cos square beta, which gives the interference pattern due to diffracted light waves from the two slits. So that means that these are the factors on which the intensity in the resultant pattern which depends. So where I is equal to half square, which is equal to 4 A square sin square alpha by alpha square, then cos square beta, the expression for intensity. When the intensity which depend on two factors, say sin square alpha by alpha square, which gives the diffraction pattern due to each individual states, cos square beta, which gives the interference pattern due to diffracted light waves from the two slits. Where 4 is constant, where A square is constant, sin square alpha by alpha square, so that is due to diffraction pattern. Cos square beta, that is due to interference pattern. The net intensity I is equal to R square, because the intensity I is equal to 2 pi square F square A square rho square rho V. That means intensity of the wave is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude. So I is equal to 2 pi square F square A square rho V. So that means the expression for intensity of the wave. So from that equation we say that I is proportional to square of the amplitude. So that means I is proportional to R square. And R square is equal to 4 A square sin square alpha by alpha square into cos square beta. So this is the expression for intensity of the wave. The diffraction term sin square alpha by alpha square gives a central maximum in the direction theta is equal to 0, having alternately minima and secondary maxima of decreasing intensity on either side. The minima are obtained in the directions given by sin alpha is equal to 0, then alpha is equal to plus or minus m pi, where pi d sin theta by lambda, which is equal to plus or minus m pi, because where alpha, which is equal to pi d sin theta by lambda, then d sin theta is equal to plus or minus m pi, where m, so 1, 2, 3, except 0, where m, which can take an integer values, so except 0. So that means the direction of central maximum, then the direction of secondary minima, and the direction of, say, secondary maxima. Now you see the diagram. So what about the interference, that means a diffraction pattern which obtained due to diffraction of light. So the central maxima, which has a brightest, which has more intensity when compared to all other fringes or bands, that means the diffraction pattern which consists of central brightest fringe is surrounded by the alternating secondary minima and secondary maxima. So as shown in the diagram, where alpha is equal to 0, that is the position of central maximum. Alpha is equal to pi, that is the position of the minimum. So then again, so alpha is equal to 2 pi, that is the position of second minima. So like that, the diffraction pattern which consists of alternating bright and dark, alternating minima and maxima with the central brightest maxima, brightest fringe. The interference term cos square beta gives a set of equidistant dark and bright fringes as in a Young's Roboslet experiment, interference experiment. Their bright fringes are obtained in the directions given by cos square beta is equal to 1, where beta which is equal to plus or minus n pi, and pi by lambda into d dash plus d sine theta which is equal to plus or minus n pi. So where beta which is equal to pi by lambda into d dash plus d sine theta. So then further, so which can be written as d dash plus d sine theta which is equal to plus or minus n pi, where n which can takes the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. The various maxima corresponding to n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 are 0 order, so first order, then the second order maxima. So now you see the diagram which indicates what about the interference pattern which obtained. That means the interference pattern which consists of the alternating bright and dark fringes. The intensity distribution in the resultant diffraction pattern is a plot of the product of the constant term 4a square diffraction term sin square alpha by alpha square and the interference term cos square beta. The entire pattern may be considered as a consisting interference fringes due to light from both slits. The intensities of these fringes being governed by the diffraction occurring at the individual slits. So now this is the diagram. So first, that means where the first diagram that indicates the graphical representation in case of a diffraction. So second one that indicates the graphical representation of intensity of the fringes in case of interference pattern. So the third factor that indicates, so that means the graphical representation of intensity of the fringes in case of a Fraunhofer diffraction at double slits. So that means the expression for intensity of light. So that means in this case we discussed about the diffraction pattern, then Fraunhofer diffraction at double slit, the experimental arrangement, then the procedure of the experiment, and the theoretical discussion, then the expression for intensity of the fringe on the screen, then the graphical representation of the intensity of the fringes with respect to phenomenon of diffraction, and then the phenomenon of interference, and in case of both interference and diffraction, and so on. Thank you.